Hey everybody, this is Jon Schwabish from PolicyViz. Recently I published a blog post about Wayne Gretzky and Alexander Ovechkin and sort of the size of the goalies that each of them had to face. This is kind of a fun data exercise in looking at hockey. And I wanted to do just a quick tutorial on how I made this particular table slash Gantt chart in both Tableau and Excel. And I've done some other videos about tables in Tableau, which I can't say I'm a huge fan of, but I wanted to show how I made this table in both of these tools. So this is what it looks like in Excel without these columns here. That's not part of it. So just this table here. And then over in Tableau, this is what it looks like. You can see here, it's just a dashboard, and I'll come back to this and show you how I did it in a second. Let's start with the Excel version. Obviously, I'm a longtime Excel user. This was pretty basic and easy and fast for me, but I'm gonna flip over here to this second tab to show you how I did it. Columns E and F are the first year and the last year of each player's career. And then along this row here, which I've sort of just made bigger so you can see it, I just have the calendar year. And so there's a quick formula in here. It's a little if formula. You can see it up in the formula bar here. All it says is if the year along the row is in between the player's first year and the last year, put in the number one. And if it's not, if it's outside that range, give it the number zero. So as you can see here, for Wayne Gretzky, 1945, it's a zero. For Gordie Howe here in 1947, 1947 is between 1947 and 1980, obviously inclusive, and that gets the number one. We'll go down here to see Phil Esposito. You can see his first year, 1964, and so 1964 is at the beginning of that range, and so it gets a one. That's done. Select all those cells. Go to conditional formatting and say, okay, the cell value is equal to one, make it red. If it's not, leave it blank and you're good to go. And then I added this little just like light fill all the way across the rows because I'm focusing on Ovechkin and Gretzky in this particular post. And then I sort of cleaned it up a little bit, you know, added these three columns here, no big deal. Added each of the years in here, which is like a merged cell, and then drew these lines and I'm good to go. So actually, I didn't find this one that difficult to do in Excel. It's just basically a little stripe chart where you just sort of collapse things down and you don't add any separators in the cells and you're good to go. What about Tableau? All right, sort of a different process. I don't think you can do this in one sheet. So I had to do it across separate sheets and build a dashboard. So the first piece is the Gantt chart. And the Gantt chart itself is actually fairly simple. If you know anything about Tableau, you've probably made something like this before. I want names along the rows, so I'm going to pull that into the rows shelf. I want the first year over here in the column shelf, and I'm going to change that to identify the year specifically, so I get these little dashes. And then the duration, which I've actually just created here, is the difference between the last year and the first year. Simple calculated field, and I'm just going to drop that into the size, and I've got myself a Gantt chart. That was pretty simple. You can sort it, et cetera, et cetera. Go on, go on. All right, table, also pretty simple. Not a huge fan of tables in Tableau right now, as you may have seen in some of my previous videos. Here, I drop name and career. Career is just that text field in this table. And then you can see here, there is this extra column. And so what I did was just squeeze it down. Now you can still see the little dot there, which I guess is the very bottom part of the A in ABC. Haven't yet figured out, and maybe I could go back and look at one of Kevin Florlich's videos on the same playlist to see how he did it. That would be a way to do it. And then on the right side, again, similar sort of thing. Here I'm hiding, I have name over here, there it is, in the first column, and I've hidden that. And I've also made the text of the player's names white and really shrunk it down. And so I just squeezed that over. Now it's interesting that I haven't been able to figure out how to hide the little bars that show the sorting, right? So let's go to our Gantt dashboard over here. So I just place these together. You can't really see, I made it too big. So if I squeeze this down, there's that little dot right there. That's the top of the bar for the sorting. So this is as far as I kind of got here. And so I used Kevin's technique that he showed in a previous video of dropping an object into here and then dropping these three guys into the object so they would line up very nicely. So this is, it's close. You can see, you know, maybe these bars need to be aligned just a little bit more. There we go. Okay, so it's pretty close. I don't love that there's this gap here, right? Because I had to squeeze out the names again by just shrinking that all the way down, you know, sort of pulling that as far over as I could. So there's probably some improvements yet to be made here, but I'm not going to spend a ton of time in it. because I think for this particular chart type, I think I would just go with Excel. I think it's faster and it's easier. You know, maybe it's harder to get out of Excel as a static image that's sort of a high resolution, and there's not the interactivity that Excel affords you, or Tableau affords you, excuse me. But I'm not sure I need interactivity here. Like, I just want this basic picture, and in the Excel version, you can see I get that basic picture pretty easy to form. So there you go. Two ways to do the Gantt chart in Excel. If you want to learn more about where I got the data, how I process the data, my process using Excel for the visualizations, Tableau for the visualizations, Stata for the data wrangling, and R to collect the data, head over to the couple of blog posts that I publish and you can learn more about it. If you want to learn more about Tableau or Excel, subscribe to this channel, check out some of the videos, and let me know if you have thoughts, critiques, comments, and other ways to make some of these visualizations. All right, thanks again for watching.